Taking a look at the Magpie, which is an open source, mostly 3D printed printer. Let's take a look. Here with the designer.
Hi, I'm Wilkes. This is the Magpie, mostly printed, has some Rook DNA, is basically what happens when you do ship a Theseus to a Rook 180 by Rolon, and then you don't stop modifying it. It prints about 200 millimeters a second with like 2000 acceleration, so not the craziest printer, but you can get a pretty good stealth printer cover in about 2.5 hours out of it. It prints ABS really well. It prints PLA almost as good, and then it prints it just as good if you lift the lid up like you do on a K1. There's a number of features of it kinematically that it shares with the K1 and the Bambu printers, that they're Core XYs. So it's got a lead screw, three lead screws driven by one belt and one motor. That's a simplification on the Trident design that I agree with Bambu doing. When they commercialize it and make it cheaper. But I wanted a printed frame, and I want it to be as accessible as possible. This is an ender bed, but you can put a Prusa bed on here if you put an adapter on there. I've tried it at home. It works pretty well. Electrically, it just kind of works the same way. The hot end is a Bambu hot end. You can use either a clone or an official one. And if you want to, you can even use something more premium, like the stuff that you get from Big Tree Tech, or even from these guys over at Swiss 3DC. The tool head is designed to flip up, so maintenance is pretty easy. You just secure it in with two screws, and the flipping front plate portion of it holds the fans and the Z-probe. The Z-probe is a Prusa Super Penda, or a clone of it, whichever one works. It's a fairly reliable printer given its printed nature, partially because I decided to make the frame parts as thick as I could, and also because I looked at what houses in places that have a lot of seismic activity are built like, and in particular, I looked at Japan. Their carpentry has a lot of sort of wood block designs to it, and it helps with vibration. It also helps with being more stable and more stiff and rigid in more than one axis at a time when you do something like this. There's a number of problems with a polymer frame that had to be overcome. One of them is squareness. And I addressed this by having the frame be adjustable to a certain extent. So these slots here pull out, or sorry, if you undo these screws, you can pull the slots out and push them in slightly. That's not so much that you can extend the printer. It's more that you can loosen these on all sides, move it up to the front, and when you tighten it, you know you're good there. You move it to back, you tighten it, you know you're good there. So you can square up the printer after the fact, despite having a polymer frame. It's really important to me that this be easy to print. As such, there's no supports required for any component on this. And also, it's printable on printers smaller than itself. So if you have a Prusa Mini or an A1 Mini, both of those will print it. It is a printer that, despite its origin of being one of originally being like created out of frustration and me just wanting a better Rook, has incorporated a lot of features that I really think are important to me. And I think it's really important that people be able to print their own printers. And I really want to see more rep wraps that are more rep wrappable. That's the long and short of it. It prints ABS great, prints PLA pretty okay. PET G, there's some resonance issues. I know what's causing them. They're fixable. Input shaping fixes it.
Excellent. Now, these are really interesting looking machines. It's one of the better printed printers that I've seen in quite a while. So everything is available on GitHub, or?
Yes. So this is where the little asterisk comes on. So yes, everything that I have done is in fact available on GitHub. However, in my lead up to the show, I did not have a chance to generate a bomb. So bill of materials will be coming very shortly. Actually, it may be up by the time this sees anything. I don't know. Probably. There's no build guide for it yet. That's going to be coming soon. I'm going to be making that a priority, but that takes time because that's its own skill, and that's I got to cultivate it before I can do it right. Yeah. I'd like to have kits available at some point. I don't know what that looks like, but I want to get this in the hands of as many people that want to have it as they can possibly have it, whether that means self-sourcing it, buying it from somebody else. I just want more printers to be more open and more printable.
Excellent. Well, it's really good work. I look forward to seeing how things go along. Yeah. And if you're interested, you can check out the files at github.com/magpie-printer. Wilkes, thanks a lot for taking a couple of minutes. We're getting ready to start packing up here, but it was a pleasure to talk with
you. Thank you so much. Thank you for taking the time to come take a look at this.
Oh, not at all.
Yeah.
Happy to do it. Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you.